Hello YouTube, this is Praveen for TechEmpty. Here in this video, we're going to see the procedure on how you can replace CMOS battery in the case if you're getting an error like press F1 to continue or press F1 to run the setup when you boot the Windows computer even though the devices are connected. And if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, please hit the red subscribe button down below and hit the bell icon to learn something new. So without any further ado, let's get started.
If you have any kind of problem with the computer's hardware, like fail to detect the hard disk or keyboard, etc., this method won't work. This method only works when the computer detects all devices like keyboard, mouse, etc. and still you see the error like press F1 to continue or press F1 to run setup. Even though you turn off the error by tweaking the BIOS settings, you will still see the same message soon after you boot the computer, and it is not the solution to this problem. You actually need to fix this. So to permanently fix press F1 to continue or press F1 to run setup error, you must replace the CMOS battery. Here is the battery number CR2032 that you need to purchase from any electrical store or Home Depot or Target. Once you have the new battery with you, unplug all computer connections, then open the cabinet by unscrewing the bolts. There you see the motherboard, and here is the CMOS battery that helps to serve the right date and time and also stores the system hardware settings. So when you tweak some settings at the BIOS, they remain unchanged when the CMOS battery drains. To fix, you just need to replace it. Now take the tester or screwdriver, then gently press to the side to pop out the current CMOS battery. When it comes out, just replace with the new battery, then close the cabinet lid. Now reconnect all the cables, then try to boot the computer. If you still see the error, get into BIOS settings by pressing the keys F2 or delete, and it depends on the manufacturer. Here let me switch to advanced mode. Now move to boot options, then disable wait for F1 if error, then save the settings. Now you don't see the error message, right? When you see the Windows login screen, restart the computer, then again go to boot options by entering into BIOS settings, then enable wait for F1 if error, and then save the settings. That's it. You replaced the CMOS battery to fix press F1 to continue or press F1 to run setup error. If you still see the error, you need to troubleshoot the error hardware like hard disk, keyboard, mouse, etc.
That's it for this quick video. I hope you find this video useful. If you do, please hit the like button and consider sharing this video with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more awesome videos like these. Your contribution is more to us. This is Praveen signing off. Hope to see you in my next video. Thank you.